So while we're debating over whether the public should be allowed access to the horrific images from Newtown, there's a whole bunch of other information that's being accessed of which we know very little about. According to the digital-based newsroom The Guardian, a court order shows that the National Security Agency, NSA, is collecting the phone records of millions of U.S. Verizon customers. On top of that, recently obtained top secret documents show both the NSA and FBI are data mining from 9 of the leading U.S. internet companies. That data that they are mining, according to the Washington Post, includes audio, video, chats, photographs, emails, documents, and connection logs. Here's what National Intelligence Director James Clapper had to say to NBC's Andrea Mitchell yesterday in an exclusive interview.
Well, the notion that we're trolling through everyone's emails and voyeuristically reading them or listening to everyone's phone calls is on its face absurd. We couldn't do it even if we wanted to, and I assure you, we don't want to.
So, John, James was like, we don't want to read your email. Keep your email.
You're
trying to
boring.
Buy terrorists. Yeah.
You people
are like, please tweet less. Yes.
Yeah.
Right,
yeah. Well, boy, the second he used the word voyeuristically looking, I thought to myself, gosh, it opened up this whole new notion that a bored NSA person at 2 a.m. might in fact be voyeuristically looking through emails. I hadn't thought of it that way.
Right.
Look, here's the bottom line on this issue, and this is a huge issue, but it's a huge issue being addressed at this point completely out of context. Mm-hmm. The fact of the matter is, in 2006, 2007, Russ Feingold, the chair of the Constitution Subcommittee of the Senate Judiciary Committee, said, they're taking our emails, they're data mining this stuff, they're listening in. I mean, he was talking about all of this. If you go back and look at the articles from 2006, I wrote them, and they're talking about the same thing. So what we've got now is confirmation. I think it upsets some people that Barack Obama is doing some of the same things George Bush did, and we thought that he would be very, very different.
But who thought that? Who thought that presidents would be different than presidents? I got to say, like, if you thought that, you're bad. Presidents are Democrat, Republican, black, white, Chicago, Midwest, South. That presidents really like control over.
I wrote that at the time.
Yeah.
But here's one thing that is really vital to put this in context.
Yeah.
And we've spent, in this new book we've spent a lot of time looking at the digitalization of politics.
Mm-hmm.
And one thing people should be very, very conscious of is if they think the NSA is trolling through their data, you should look at what political candidates and political parties are doing, and you should look at what corporations are doing.
And you know, actually, it's the corporations that actually make me most, I guess part of what I find interesting about the outrage is, sure, I understand the outrage around the NSA. Mm-hmm. I also recognize them as part of a democratically elected government, which at least in theory is responsive. Google and Facebook and Twitter and all of these to whom I just simply give away my information are corporations that aren't, there's no even imagination that they would be responsive, and we tend to give this information away to them.
Well, I'm suing Google and Facebook right now.
Yep,
because,
I know this.
They have tracked their users, and in some cases, their non-signed-up users' internet surfing habits. They can tell what articles you've read. They can tell what your politics are. They can tell what you buy.
Yep.
And the danger of that is obvious. Nobody should know that much about you.
Mm-hmm.
And there ought to be transparent privacy policies that let people opt out of these services rather than you having to go through one page after another and read fine print and whatnot and then ultimately be confused about what the privacy policy is, which is today's state of play. And so we're suing them because we believe they violated the Wiretap Act.
Mm-hmm.
Now, let's take it a step further. We always believed that one of the reasons we ought to stop this corporate data mining is because the government was going to get it.
Mm-hmm.
And the government can get it very easily on top of the table, and now we find that they're getting it under the table. And this is a vast data mining project unlike anything in the history of the world. There is nobody that knows more about us as individuals today than ever before. That includes Soviet Russia. That includes China. That includes all of the nations of the world. So this is big time stuff. This isn't stuff to sneeze at. And Big Brother has arrived. And you know how he arrived? With the best of intentions. We were always afraid he would. We would always wonder whether or not Americans are going to say security trumps everything, and that's how dictatorships get started.
Right. I mean, I'm obsessed with adolescent dystopic novels. I read them as my sort of airplane reading, and it's always about these authoritarian societies that begin with the best of intentions for the purpose of making people safe and happy and secure. And in both the kind of Newtown photos case and in this case, it's in part a question about individual liberties and how much we're willing to take even the negative aspects that come with individual liberties because we see liberty itself as such a value.
But it's a bigger question. It's a bigger question because this is changing our politics and our lives. The fact of the matter is when, and I know we're talking about the corporate, being very concerned about the corporations. Understand this. When political parties and candidates rely on data mining to determine how they communicate and who they reach out to, they begin the game of piecing together a narrow coalition instead of those visionary statements that, that might build a governing coalition that could actually do something. We are narrowing our discourse.
So they start, sell us a government instead of, trying to create a
government. That's not healthy.
My only concern with that argument is that, yes, political campaigns and, yes, corporations are a problem. They might lead to a mailer. They might lead to a phone call. But NSA leads to an arrest. NSA leads to a lifetime in detention.
So it's the power it's the power of the state and
this
the idea that the state has.
Not diminish that at all. But it is to say that we need to understand that, you know, I mean, we actually still think of the word propaganda as an unsettling thing, right?
There's another problem about it as well, which is that there's a predictive quality to it. So all of the big data and all of the data mining and the pattern of our lives that they can put together from that can be used to predict, for instance, that you are profiled as the kind of person that is likely to commit a crime. So in the, you can be detained
and then
in
surveillance
preventive
begins.
Detention.
Tom Cruise did a movie about that.
Right. And this is now landed for real.
Well, and in fact, actually, I'll make a claim that, that we already do that, and we just do it on less predictive data like skin color. I just want to say thank you so much, Professor Wexler, for joining us. The rest of the panel is staying around for more. Up next, Downward Dog and the Devil. Wow. Seriously?